two reasons to be here. I'm desperately recruiting. And I need about 100 of you to come back with me as soon as possible. One more observation I will give you about these events. I'm typically asked to take this great degree, this honor, and then I say, well, what would you like me to say? And almost without exception, it's some version of, well, do you take a few minutes and give them some advice on how to succeed? And then I think, they've all had you for 4 years. They've probably got $100,000 or more of your money and your parents' money. And they want me in that last couple of minutes to be the one that gives you advice on how to succeed. Okay. Well, I have dutifully figured out how to do that. We might not get done by exactly noon. I made a list of the 100 things you need to do to succeed in life. I'll go through it quickly, don't worry. Number one, figure out something important to do. You have engineering skills, as I keep saying. We've been trying to collect the smartest engineers out of the best schools in the world, and I keep getting directed here. So I'm pretty sure you have the skills to do it, but find an important problem to apply those skills to.
In the university, I hereby admit you to your various and several degrees with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations.
They are your best cheerleaders. And to your classmates, say thank you. Many will be your friends for life. Tomorrow, you will step into a new adventure. It will be an exciting one. It will be fast, it will be complex, challenging, and sometimes hard to understand. Before you leave on that journey, take these three things with you. Number one, remember your roots. The world is your oyster. It will sparkle and tempt you. But always remember where you were born, when you went to school, and the many people who have shaped your life, even the ones you don't like. Number two, regardless of what you do in life, the question you should always ask is not at what cost, but rather at whose cost. Engineering is about envisioning, creating, and making a difference for others. Even if you move away from engineering work, you have chosen this education and you are now wearing an ring. You therefore owe a duty of care to your neighbors and to your community, to society. Number three, be humble. You know you have the ability, now find your motivation. Whatever you do, do it with love in your heart. You don't have to become the best engineer in the room, but find the path that will help you become the best person you can be. Thank you for choosing Water Your Engineering. We are proud of you. You have made us laugh, and sometimes you even made us cry. Now go out and do great things. And as I invite George Dixon, the Vice President of Academic Provost, back to the program, to the podium, I want to say from all of us in the Faculty of Engineering, have a good life and may the force be with you.
Thank you. Between years, can we set up a class profile, which we're going to talk about. So he's done a lot of things to really help the class, and so I also really want to appreciate that. So you two are the second and third people to get this award last year. Please, now you've got the award as well.